What up, big boys, and welcome to the Reject Demon Toko Chapter 0 Prelude. Which is a... that's a name, isn't it? That's a name. Okay, I think it's a visual novel game, so let's play. Toko, it's not that bright! Stop squinting and look ahead of you! Okay. She takes a few minutes to adjust the light, and a bleary shape slowly comes into focus. What is it? Here you go, Toko!
Hey, what goes, Daddy? Actually, I think that's meant to be a woman, so maybe I should go,
hey, what goes, Daddy?
Oh my god, the tall demon's eyes, running a hand through his head before putting on a big, I'm scared, is this a sex game? No, I checked, it isn't. This here is your first soul, she's going to die soon, and it's your job to do the reaping.
I don't want anyone to die, Daddy!
The demon's smile grows a little strained before he crouches to meet his daughter's eyes. That's his daughter? It's awkward. Nothing we can do, Toko. If this girl's supposed to die, we have to be here to receive her soul. It's our job! It's very important. It is really important. That's what I say.
But she...
It's the natural order of things. At least she must die, sweetie. But if she dies without us being there for her, her soul will be lost to one of the earth forever. That's worse. I mean, I'd rather die than do that.
So we're actually helping...
We're actually helping her.
He stands up straight again, brushing off his knees. Toko remains unenlightened, oh my god, by his argument. Though it may seem just a little bit hard for you now, by ferrying these souls, we actually do a lot of good for these humans. It's also what we require to survive. Well, yeah, I thought you'd probably just say that.
How come?
Can you put your trousers up a bit? I'm fairly sure this is like incest. Clay reaches out and pats her on the head. Like any kid, she often asks the hardest questions, so that's awkward. Well, as you get older, you'll realise it, Toko. Us demons don't eat what these humans do. As you grow, you'll depend more on helping these souls to hell. So you can be big and strong. That's good, right? He puffs off, oh god, it's right! Taking in a small kind of victory of his father trying his best, and turns Toko around, nudging her towards the girl in the distance. Oh, this is awkward. Is there anything to do? Now go on, there isn't much time. Come on, kill her. The tall demon leaves Toko to perform her task. She takes a determined breath and focuses ahead. A little human girl, oblivious to the danger present, is wandering towards the busy street. She looks concerned, sniffling as she rubs her eyes. She takes another step off the sidewalk into the street. She's gonna run over.
Hey!
Toko grabs her hand and pulls the girl back. Oh, the little cutie helped her. Oh, I'm probably not gonna call it shit, that's probably illegal. The human girl turns around to look at the demon in surprise. Ooh.
Why are you crying? Why are you crying?
The girl sniffles again, nodding fervently. She squeezes Toko's hand. Toko pauses, looking at the girl on a busy road. A truck zooms in by a little too closely and then takes a cautious step back. Ooh.
You see me well?
Oh, I can't remember what was her voice. It was either. I think it was.
You see me? You see me well? Sure is scary.
I think that was it. Toko looks suddenly quite nervous while glancing down at the hand she's holding. Then go, the girl giggles.
Sorry! Well.
I hope you're watching this, not just listening to this, otherwise, you're still going to be able to hear what I'm saying.
You're missing your ball, right?
Toko quickly changes the subject while puffing up her chest and patting it with her hand.
I'll help you look for it. If we look together, we'll find it really fast.
Oh, this game has some nice little sprites and graphics, you have to say.
Thank you. I'm alone.
The girl smiles, hugging it tightly to her chest.
No problem. You're okay, right?
The girl looks at the ball and back up to Toko, humming.
What? Hey, my daddy, I think.
I'm not really good at voice acting, am I? She leans in curious. Oh.
Where are you from?
Well, Demonland, maybe? Demonland?
Huh? Demonland? Are you a demon? Okay, they were scary, but you're nice.
Toko huffs, twiddling her fingers.
Demons can be scary.
Demons.
Demons can be.
Oh, I can't remember what was it. You know the Yog Pod? I think it was meant to be like the girl that says,
Mommy, can I listen to the Yog Pod?
Okay.
Demons can be scary sometimes, but I'm really brave. Oh.
Tokyo pauses a bit and then looks at her feet.
Actually, Daddy Hughes 111 says I'm supposed to find a soul. A human soul or something.
The girl's eyes grow wide with curiosity and she shuffles in closer.
A human soul? Well, now you said everyone has a soul, so I doubt it's going to be hard to find one. Nice meme. Yes, but I don't think I can easily get one. Hey, help me run a ball. Oh, I have an idea.
She places the ball down, cautiously standing between her feet as though it might try to roll away with her. Then she pulls out a scrap of paper and a bright red crayon. Does she? That's nice. That's a nice way to do it, isn't it?
I'll give you mine. You can buy it for mine if you want.
I don't think that's really how you can...
You can show your daddy this. It's definitely a shop. Yes?
Oh, wait, what was it? This isn't... So, the girl on the right has the... And Toko has the slightly less mad, which is the...
You just put it down on a piece of paper.
That's it, yeah.
Yeah, it. Yeah.
Well, she's sure this couldn't have been what Clay meant, Toko grabs the scraps. The girl gives a proud nod, picking up her ball again. It'll be the first time. Hey! Who's Nadia? Oh, is that her? Wow.
I don't know you since you need it, right? I definitely won't.
God's sake. I think that's a bit too similar.
That's...
Toko pauses. That girl? Nadia? She must be a goddess. Oh, God. Okay.
Yes, that's awesome. Thanks, Nadia. I'm glad I could help you find your ball, but I have to go now. Daddy must be wondering why I'm taking so long. I'll help you anytime.
Nadia shuffles a bit.
Thank you, Toko. I should get home, you're a really great demon.
Never thought I'd ever write you're a really great demon in that voice. Or even just on its own. The girl scampers off. Toko briefly looks down at a piece of paper and beams.
Does he?
Oh. Okay,
Toko!
Ah?
How did it go?
Toko holds up the paper up and beams.
Clay
looks puzzled for a minute and tilts his head, glancing at the human girl running up the street. Why has he not, like, got clothes on? Can you not just, like, why do demons, like, High School DxD could say, why do they have to be, like, all like this?
Nothing happened to her. She gave you this instead and left.
Toko folds this piece of paper and carefully puts it in her pocket. Ooh.
Did I do something wrong?
No.
Clay begins to wave his hands frantically.
You did the best you could. I'm trying, my little girl. But we better get back home quick, yeah? Sorry. Boy, I think she's gonna kill me.
As Clay walks back to the door to hell, Toko follows behind with her head still on earth. I like these animations.
Did she tell me her name?
Oh, did she? I think she did. I think. I can't remember. Alright. Oh, Lou, peace off. Ripple soft. Up by Towson, riding by Kelly Pelton. Down your hands and Mickle. Oh, going a bit fast. Movie designed by Rado MSS. Movie managed by Armstrong. Ooh. Oh, oh my god, what is going on there? Oh, is that nothing? It's very similar to the other guy. Oh, okay, this is literally High School DxD. Is she an elf? Oh, there's some rock music playing. Oh my god, this is lagging. Oh god, ignore this. Has it crashed? Has it crashed on me? This really intensive game lagged on me. It's crashing on me. Come on. Oh god, look at this little scrub lord over here, don't know how to run a game. It's awkward, isn't it? Unless I'm meant to click. Oh, I am. Humans weave through thousands of myths about the underworld, whether it's called Hell, Jakugu, Tartarus, or Dee. I've never heard of any of those other than the first one, but sure. It is the place the damned are sentenced to suffer eternally for their sins. While all good legends have their roots in truth, Hell is merely the realm of demons, Ferrarias and caretakers. The underworld, who guide the souls of mortals to the afterlife aboard the demon ferry. Whether it's soon or late, it doesn't matter. All humans are destined to die at some point in their lives. Once a human reaches their end, a ferry is assigned to guide their soul to limbo. It is there that souls must purify themselves, or they may ascend into the afterlife or return to the overworld to be reborn. These demons that perform this duty without recompense. As with each soul, a demon ferries, they savor a memory of their soul's life and that power that comes with it. Soul of a demon is incomplete, lacking in emotion and empathy. All that is an incomplete demon can feel is the need to remove the void they are born with. That hunger for memory, emotion, and passion internally drives them to consume the souls of humans. Millennia passed. Demons would surge in great and terrible masses upon the overworld to quell this hunger inside them. It was not long before starvation and fighting and occasional lawsuit forced the demons to realize that the vast conception of humanity was unsustainable. In order to survive without constant war between themselves, demons devised the Demon Code in the role of the pharaohs who escort souls. With each passing and subsequent pharaoh, they obtain the necessary nourishment to get stronger and prosper. Most young demons are quick to ferry their first soul. It's a rite of passage into old adulthood. However, one demon has failed every attempt given to her. The only zero soul demon in hell. This is her story. It's Toko, isn't it? In the upper middle row sits a young woman, her head resting on her test books. Hopefully not to fast play it on the desk. Ah, that'd be a nice name, wouldn't it? Each tick of the second hand was slower than the last. Oh, God, that's school idea. Oh, boy. I wish that clock had animation. It's sort of shameful. A mechanical pencil taps against it. Mechanical pencil? What's a mechanical pencil? I mean, oh, unless that's one of those when you go and then more of it comes out. Might be it. Taps against her desk and sinks the clock, disconnected and unaware. Every couple of minutes, she glances at the clock. 15 minutes left. Oh, God. Flips to a blank page in her notebook and fills it with incoherent notes and doodles. 14 minutes. Oh, my 14! This is the last class of the day and far from her favourite. Oh, boy. She often wished her most boring one at the beginning of the day, but she was stuck in the circle. I don't know if I would, though. I mean, actually, yeah, I guess. 8 minutes left. 6, 4, get out! Finally! Christ! The professor is in the middle of announcing the reading assignments for the next week. As it's a Friday, all of her classmates rush to leave as quickly as possible. She drags herself into the bustling hallway. Oh my God! Is that what she like looks like now? I mean, she's developed, I guess. Okay. Over the roar of freshmen, she hears the voice of her friend. Oh no, it's not her. Okay. Oh no, that would be. Oh, I don't know. Okay, what should her voice be? Maybe like a.
Nadia.
That's good. Right?
Nadia.
Okay,
I'm sorry, I didn't know you spanking fast, I was busy taking notes.
I don't know if that was her or not. my memory's the worst, I'm like voice acting.
Hey, don't worry, everyone was bored by that lesson. We were all planning to go out to Mammoth Burger in a bit, want to join us?
That's kind of a bit weird.
I'm ready to go home and study anyway, if you go without me.
Yeah, so have a day, alright?
No! Please, don't look at me so suspiciously. I should have the study. It's one of those things university students have to do.
Oh God, I'm tired.
Okay, but I still don't trust. Okay, but I still don't trust you. Make it up to me when we catch up. Later then.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, well, yeah. I was making another reading to study.
Oh, that's sad. Sorry. Oh my God. Okay. Oh, what was her voice?
That's it. I'm just being dismissed. I don't even get a second chance.
Second chance, Toko? Do you know what I'm holding?
I know she meant to be a woman. I mean, you can sort of tell. But how do you... I can't really think of any more female voices, to be honest, but...
Second chance, Toko? Do you know what I'm holding?
My assignment record.
Your assignment record containing 417 second chances. Most teachers just wanted to assign you in the hopes it would be trivially easy. And how many of these have you succeeded at? None. You're failed to take even the simplest opportunity presented to you. We have no reason to keep a reject like you around. Okay, and we're going to end this video here, because I believe we're going into the 15 minutes now. Anyway, that's quite an ending screen, isn't it? Why all these demons have to be, like, so seductive? I mean, I guess demons are known for being seductive, right? No? What? Oh. Kind of reminds me of High School DxD, actually. Oh, that's awkward. Anyway, I mean, that's literally not even like that. It's falling off, I'm fairly sure. That could fall off. Anyway, thanks for watching me, boys. Thanks for my time. And...
bye!